Once upon a time, everything underground was above ground. And at Los Peñasquitos Canyon Preserve, there are a few students sweeping and scraping their way to the past.
This park is incredibly rich in history. Looking good.
This is Dr. Tim Gross, Associate Professor of Anthropology at San Diego City College.
Today we're continuing our ongoing excavation project here at the Peñasquitos Adobe. This is an excavation class that's part of a certificate program for students.
San Diego City College began its excavation program in 1991. Dr. Gross took over the program in 2016.
We have a very nice arrangement with the county where we work here in the spring.
We know that people have been using this area for thousands of years, and cultures have crossed over during that time. And the things that they find here kind of help us piece all of that together to really understand our resources and be able to tell the story of this incredible place.
We've had some collapse here. We have to keep exact location of everything because it's the piece of trash, the bit of metal or the horseshoe or the piece of pottery tells us that it's a horseshoe or a piece of metal. But when you find that horseshoe with nails and coal, slag, then you begin to see not just nails and coke and slag, but a blacksmith shop. What are you seeing, Erica? That looks like it might be cow, huh?
Dr. Gross was a high school volunteer at San Diego State and the Museum of Man.
I've been doing this for 50 years now.
Throw me the idol, I throw you the whip. Give me the whip.
Adios, senor.
Comparing him to Indiana Jones might be a stretch, though.
Indiana Jones, you know, was shown as working for a museum, and you sort of get the notion that stuff goes back to the museum, but everything that I excavated and have through my entire career winds up in a facility that can take care of it in perpetuity so we can continue to learn from it. Even if I've reported it very well by 2020 standards, in 2050 there'll be new techniques that they can look at that same material and learn more without having to dig up more sites. Another difference is that I don't have a whip. And you'll notice there are no sidearms.
What he does have is plenty of experience that comes in handy with his diverse group of students.
I started out in a biological anthropology class, and I found out that I loved learning more about archaeology and bones and all of that, and this was a really good way to experience it firsthand.
I had found an obsidian arrowhead, and I found it on my first dig, and it blew my mind. So from there, it just lit the fire, and here I am.
Everybody is pleased to be here. They're working hard. They are each one trying to learn the skills.
Skills that include mapping and screening to note-taking. But Dr. Gross can't do it all alone.
So you guys have already been explained why we pedestal things.
Amy Ross is one of his assistants at Los Peñasquitos.
What's great about this program and working for a county park is that these students get to see what it's like to do it in the U.S. A lot of academic archaeology that you get at university is, you know, Peru or the pyramids. It's a great opportunity to do this locally at a much lower cost and prepare these students for what it really means to be an archaeologist here and not just doing the big fancy stuff.
Visiting the ranch house is wonderful, and we hope to keep adding to the story that they tell in the museum there. So keep checking back.